In Nepal, somebody told me, said, sir, it is DLTS. I said, what is DLTS? They said, Danda Late Total Sanitation. People are beaten up and they're fined and etc. I said, that's not somehow. Say, you know, answering this question, you know, it's a huge question, you know. CLTS, Community Late Total Sanitation, go anywhere in India, any district, people will tell you that we are doing CLTS. But to me, it's a hugely diluted CLTS, and one of the serious risk is that India might become the graveyard of CLTS, you know, because what has been institutionalized is the techniques of CLTS, triggering tools and this and that. So, as a result, community, the way they are supposed to react, they have been reacting. But then I was showing the slide here, the boulder, that the whole blockade. Okay, we are going to stop it, clean it, everything. We are going to give me money. The moment the money comes, where's the money? Okay, then whole list of complexities come in. Well, you don't get it because your grandfather took some money on TSC, Total Sanitation Campaign. Your father got it, so you are not eligible. Your grandfather got it in, the NBA or Nirmal Bharat Abhiyan, so you are not eligible. This and this and that, you are not under that. It's a whole host of, you know, selection criteria imposed by outsiders. They are not their criteria. So, while in the name of targeting the poor, you are in fact dividing the community. CLTS, when you trigger, it's exactly you did this opposite thing. Everybody together, the bhaichara, you know, that we are helping each other, the social solidarity, that you may be poor, I may be poor, but you know, somebody is saying that you please don't defecate in the open. I'll give you some planks and this and that and bamboos and take me this land, you know. But everybody is trying to achieve that main target, the public good, that nobody defecates in the open. And that's where you get the health outcome. So that's what is not happening. Subsidy is stopping it. But at the same time, I must say that with our Prime Minister's Swachh Bharat Mission, it has given a huge boost to the sanitation movement. Although they have been talking about in Government of India's policy, they are talking about focus on behavior change, not the toilet. But in reality, they have been chasing toilets. Toilet construction, and you must have seen from NBA, the subsidy amount has increased to 12,000 now. And it's all again toilet. So that is that old traditional concept of sanitation was based on the assumption people are poor, give them money. People don't understand, teach them hygiene education. They can't construct toilet, prescribe toilet models. That's the thing, but CLTS is exactly opposite. Assumptions of CLTS are people may be poor, may not be that much of educated, but they're human beings. No human beings in the world want to live in shit and ingest each other's shit. For CLTS to happen, three things must come. One is attitude behavior change. Whose attitude behavior change? Ours. Professionals, planners, senior people, politicians, district magistrate, that they can do it. When the behavior change takes place, it becomes demand driven. They come to you, they go to the shops, because these children and women would not like to go to the bush again, because the behavior change has taken place. You will continue to have this district here, that district here. What does that mean? India has got, you know, so many districts. Half of the country's population defecating in the open. Problem is huge, you know. So if we fail to produce the right policy that empowers local community to change their own behavior, we'll be struggling. It will continue to be our own program, government-led, this and that. It should not be our headache. Now, Since the time I developed it, it's now in more than 70 countries, Asia, Africa, Latin America. More than 30 countries, national sanitation strategy, policy, from subsidy, it has changed to CLTS, no subsidy. I don't think they are fools, but one different, I mean, they are different from us in one way, is that they don't have, those governments do not have so much of money to waste, particularly the poor countries in Africa. And Bangladesh was the third poorest country when I developed it, from 35% in back in the the late 90s, they have moved to 99%. I mean, you can say it's not the money. And Nepal took a few years to understand this, 4 or 5 years. Then after that, they said no subsidy. They stopped subsidy. And half of the VDCs, of 4,000 VDCs in Nepal, are open defecation free. Pakistan has achieved MDG sanitation target. They have been all using it. So the question is, why are we not using? I don't think that we don't understand. We do understand it. We very much understand it. But there has to be a decision. But this is an approach which I have seen, like the next countries, those who are very close to declaring the nation ODF, Zambia, I introduced it first in Africa, Madagascar, and Kenya. So these people, these countries are moving very fast. You can see the global report and everything. And they all stopped. They said, no, this way we can't just do it. Now it is up to the country, our own country, to decide it. We could only say, because it's a country of huge diversity, there cannot be one size, cannot fit all. So, but this is an approach, and I'm convinced this approach has worked very successfully in the state of Himachal Pradesh, some districts in Haryana, some here and there in Rajasthan, you have seen it. You talk to the best district magistrates, those who could do it. At least I met them many. They said, sir, stop subsidy today. It will be a different story. Well, they all have a defined job to do. You could all involve them. And the main powerful thing of CLTS is that it involves the civil society, not only the government departments and organizations, but the civil society. Like, do you know that there are how many mosques in there in the country? Several thousand mosques will be there. And that I have seen in Muslim countries, where it spread much faster, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Yemen, and many countries in Africa, the Muslim countries, where it straight away on the Friday prayer, the Imam is talking about CLTS. So involving them and exposing them on this CLTS kind of things, you are giving it to so many people, the churches and the temples, So, the civil society, if you hold it to only Anganwadi and this and that, etc., but you got to first understand that from constructing toilets, you have to construct human beings who will take it to the society. A great natural leader I saw when I took him with him to another village, and I was talking about it, and he didn't speak much. He took it from a thala. He brought a small model of toilet made of a salimar nariyal tail, and this and that, and he said, it's a totally a drum down below, a superstructure made of straw and everything. Usko bana ke dikha diya. Kitna time lagta hai aapko is sab mein? Sab bola to abhi bana lenge. Bola to wohi to hai. Aur kya hai? Wo bataya. Gu dekhoge, diarrhea nahi hogi. Gu sukhoge, nahi hogi. Gu haath mein lag gaya, sabun se haath dho liya, diarrhea nahi hogi. Gu khana padta hai. Bahar hag liya, koi bhi kha jayega, makhi se charon taraf phaila dega. Kya time? I was stunned, So, if you could engage thousands and thousands of natural leaders, they will transform your country. Our job, government must understand, our job should be a facilitative job, empowerment job, taking it to those things, and shift the role from chasing toilet to constructing human beings who will transform the society.